Friends, Hari Prasad is back with another lecture on soft skills. Topic for discussion is tips for conducting effective meetings. Tips for conducting effective meetings. Hours are spent in keeping minutes of the meeting. For writing minutes of the meeting, hours are spent. It is a paradoxical statement, right? Hours are spent, minutes written. Man hours spent in the meetings need to be valued. All the participants to participate at the meeting. Then meetings are effective. Define clear agenda. Address each team in the agenda. Record discussion without any prejudices. During conducting meeting, no prejudices, nothing. Record meetings directly. There should not be any prejudices. Arrange presentation equipment. Before conducting meeting, presentation equipment is to be arranged. That computer, PowerPoint presentation, everything should be ready before conducting the meeting. Distribute the agenda to the concerned. The agenda of the meeting are to be distributed among the participants. Plan for refreshments. These are all to be synchronized. Refreshments, arrangements, meeting, equipment required for meeting, all have to be synchronized. Time spent for the meeting is to be worth. Whatever time spent for meeting, that is to be worth. The quantitative details for the failure of meeting, I am giving the quantitative details for the failure of the meeting. 83% drifting of the subject. 83% of the participants, they drift of the subject. 77% poor preparation. 74% questionable effectiveness. 68% lack of listening. 62% verbosity of participants. 60% length of meeting. 51% lack of participation by all participants. These are the reasons why meetings are failures. People feel meeting is a waste of time, feel skeptical about the outcome, regard it as a necessary evil to get the work done. Meeting means what people feel generally, it is waste of time. They feel doubtful about the outcome. They regard it as a necessary evil to get the work done. These are the names given to the meetings. Meetings in the sense, so people feel like that. No meeting should be without agenda. Drag on forever. Ramble from topic to topic. And that ends without any apparent result. No meeting should end without apparent result. That means meeting should be with agenda, not without agenda. Drag on forever, hours meeting not to be dragged. Ramble from topic to topic, from this topic taking to other topic. But I am rambling here from topic to topic because I am explaining only the bare points, the bare acts, the bare points of soft skills. That's why I am rambling. But in a specific meeting, there should not be the ramble from point to point. from topic to topic, no should not be any, there should not be any ramble. So without any apparent result, if meeting is ended, what is the use? Precious hours are spent without any result. Call meeting only when important, not always meetings. For example, in government, either Andhra government or Telangana government, meetings. Why? They hold meetings. What is the use? Other companies, organizations are also holding meetings, but they are better performing than these government organizations. The private companies are better performing. Why? So many meetings not required. Meeting. You go to Andhra, go to Telangana, meeting. That means the productive time of the bureaucrats, IAS, IPS officers and other bureaucrats, small staff or bigger staff, whatever, subordinate staff or superior staff, whatever, their time is being wasted. That is why no one is sitting in his office, all in secretariat. So what about the public? Public should feel government officers, top officers, small officers, clerical staff, they always are seen in their seats. If this opinion comes to public, they elect that government again. That political party again, they elect. Why? This is the secret point. The governments should understand this. If governments are holding all meetings at secretariat all the time, one meeting in a month, finished, then public will be happy with that government. Meetings without results, without outcome, what is the use? The governments may learn from my talk. Call only important people that are necessary for meeting. Not all people, only important people necessary for that meeting, call them only. Make meetings short, not long. Preparation for the meetings. Prepare schedule 2 days in advance. Block off time. Define purpose of the meeting and the outcomes. Determine who should be there. Reserve a room, appropriate equipment. Reserve a room for that. Make appropriate equipment ready. Decide on appropriate setup. Develop agenda. Distribute the agenda prior to the meeting to the participants. Plan for coffee and refreshments. Breaks. Consider logistics. Logistics means from where we have to procure it, from where we have to store it, from where we have to distribute it. This is called logistics. Room layout, seating, distractions if any, all you need to observe well in advance. Support items like projector, whiteboard, pens, etc. The supporting items are to be made ready. Ask yourself the following questions. Are your meetings dull and uninspiring? Do team members question the usefulness of meetings? Are critical issues avoided or overlooked during meetings? Are the meetings inconclusive due to ambiguous agenda? Do you wonder? Some give only negative inputs? These are the questions ask yourself before preparing the agenda. Agenda preparation. Give ample time to participants to organize their thoughts. Send meeting agenda in advance. Bell-shaped agenda is better for meetings. Bell-shaped agenda is to structure the events around the group's energy and attention. Items in the agenda. Item 1, welcome. Item 2, minutes of the previous meeting. Item 3, announcements, not controversial. Short briefings, for example, follow-up action, upcoming events, etc. Item 4, easy item, non-controversial. Item 5, hardest item. Why in the middle, hardest item? What is the reason? Because attendance, latecomers have arrived and early leavers haven't left. That is why hardest item should be put in the midst of the meeting agenda. Attention, focused on meeting by this time. Item 6, for discussion only. After discussion on hard items, it may be good idea to have items only of discussion type to mitigate differences, if any, amongst the people in the meeting. Item 7, easiest item. End of this meeting is the beginning of the next meeting. End on positive note of agreement and encouragement. Any meeting end with positive note of encouragement and agreement. Punctuality and minutes of the meeting. Minutes are resolutions. Minutes of the meeting are resolutions of the meeting. Moderator sets a tone for all meetings. In any meeting, moderator will be there. Moderator means meeting leader. So, meeting leader sets a tone for all meetings. Inculcate sense of punctuality. Always instill sense of punctuality for attending meetings. Start on time. Participants should be punctual as well. Start the meeting on time. Participants also should be on time. Don't repeat things for those that arrive late. Some participants arriving late. Don't repeat. Go on. Let the meeting go on. Latecomers can pick up what they missed from someone after the meeting. After each item, make a brief note of the decision and note it down by the steno, note taker. Resolutions have to be simple and unambiguous. Facilitator is responsible for conducting meeting. Facilitator means that is you. Dispense minutes post meeting. Once the meeting is over, distribute the minutes to the participants. Meeting etiquette. Be punctual, already told you. Don't distract the speaker. Members trickling may distract the speaker. When one speaker is speaking, don't trickle. If members trickle, then speaker gets distracted. Take your seat. Don't walk out. Don't walk out while chairman is speaking. Ask permission if you want to leave. Question politely. Be polite and ask for clarification if you have a doubt. Apologize to the chairman if arrives late at the meeting or coughing and sneezing. Tender your apology to the chairman of the meeting. Don't take it personally. Plausible solutions for disruptive behavior of people. Plausible solutions I'm giving for disruptive behavior in meetings. Reward and thank those who were there on time. 6. Thinking heads concept. Now I am giving you 6 thinking heads concept for meeting. This is a symbiotic technique for proactive communication. 6 hats tech, 6 hats thinking process, no procedure, that is symbiotic technique for proactive communication. Applications of the concept are 6 hat theory. Applications: 1. 6 hat theory enhances the thinking process. 2. It encourages creative, parallel and lateral thinking. 3. It improves communication. 4. It speeds up decision making. 5. It removes ego, reduces confrontation. Basics of this concept: 1. There are 6 different imaginary hats that you can put or take off. There are 6 hats, 6 different hats, black, white, blue in different colors. Imaginary hats, these are imaginary hats. There are 6 different imaginary hats that you can put or take off. You can put or take off. Number 2, think of the hats as thinking icons. 3, each hat is a different color and represent a different type of thinking. 4, we all wear the same hat at the same time. That means do the same type of thinking at the same time. 5, when we change hats, we change our thinking. Change one hat, think different. Change one hat, think different. Means you need to think differently in different situations. 6 colors used in this concept and the purpose of each hat. White is objective facts and figures. Red, emotions and feelings. Black, cautious and careful. Yellow, hope, positive and speculative. Green, creativity, ideal and lateral thinking. Blue, control and organization of thinking. Purpose of each hat. Blue hat. Start meeting with a blue hat. That is, blue hat is facilitator. White hat. White hat is a discipline. Neutral, objective and informative. Red hat. Emotions and feelings. All decisions are emotional in the end. Yellow hat. Yellow hat thinking is positive and constructive. Black hat, cautious and careful. Green hat, creative thinking. Main purpose of 6 thinking hats concept is to allow a switch in thinking. To allow a switch in thinking, this 6 thinking hat concept is discovered. Finally, keep a neat control record of agenda, corresponding minutes and signature of all the attendees, participants. Before closing this lecture, I'll give you 3 rules for success. 1. Trust your brain. 2. Trust yourself. 3. Trust Hari Prasad. You can become winner in life. Thank you. Carpe diem. Thank you.
Thank you.